a celebrated has victory of goddess Durga over Mahishasura. The main message that it gives is victory of good over the evil and success of truth over lies. Why is Dasara celebrated for 9 days? The festival is associated to the prominent battle that took place between Durga and Mahishasura. Each day is associated to an incarnation of the goddess. The first day of Navaratri is dedicated to goddess Shailaputri, the first form of goddess Durga. People worship goddess Shailaputri as a girl child and the daughter of mountain king. The color of the first day is yellow. Devotees offer ghee as bhog to goddess. We worship Devi Shailaputri so that we may also attain the highest state of consciousness. On the second day of Navaratri, people worship goddess Brahmacharini. Green is known to be associated with the second day of Navaratri. Devotees offer sugar as bhog to the goddess. In this form, Devi Parvati undertook severe penance to have Lord Shiva as her partner. Brahma means divine, consciousness, and Achar refers to behavior. The third day is dedicated to goddess Chandraghanta, the goddess of peace and serenity. It is believed that praying this form of Shakti could cure all your problems in life. The color of this day is gray. Devotees offer milk to please the god. Thus, this signifies withdrawing from all vagaries of mind with a single focus on Mother Divine. Devotees on the fourth day of the festival worship goddess Kushmanda. It is believed that observing fast on this day of Navaratri could cure all the pain and diseases. Orange color is associated with fourth day. The fifth day is associated to goddess Skandamata. White is the color of this day. Devotees are expected to wear new clothes on Panchami and offer fruits, especially banana has bhog to goddess. In this form, she is the mother of Lord Kartikeya. Worshipping this form of Devi brings abundance of wisdom, wealth, power, prosperity and liberation. It is the goddess Katyayini who is worshipped on the sixth day of Navaratri. Devotees wear color red and offer honey as bhog to please the goddess. She was born from the anger of the god. She is the one who slayed Mahishasura. We worship goddess Katyayini on the sixth day to put an end to all inner enemies that are an obstacle on the path of the spiritual evolution. Seventh day of Navaratri is dedicated to goddess Kalratri. Devotees wear royal blue clothes and offer jaggery as bow. Mother Nature has two extremes. One is terrifying and devastating. The other is beautiful and serene. Kalratri represents the dark night. It is considered as one of the most ferocious form of Madhurga or Parvati who killed Raktabija. On the eighth day, people worship goddess Mahagauri. Worshipping this avatar of goddess Durga is said to mitigate all the sins of one's life. Pink is associated with the eighth day and bhog made of coconut is offered to goddess. She symbolizes the goddess of peace and endurance. Ninth day is the last day of Navaratri and is dedicated to goddess Siddhidatri. Devotees on this day break their 9-day fast and worship all the 9 forms of goddess Durga. The color of the 9th day is purple. Siddhi means perfection. Dhatri means the one who gives. Therefore, people celebrate and worship all forms of goddess enthusiastically. They make a lot of grand statues and carry out processions in her honor. In a lot of places, we see that people host fairs. Most importantly, Navaratri brings people together from all over the country and symbolizes diversity and culture.
Thank you. Thank you.